today I'm going to talk to you about one of the worst case scenarios in terms of running injury a heel strike runner may suffer versus a forefoot strike runner. The type of injury that I'm referring to in this video are long bone injuries, more specifically, how a heel strike runner may develop a femur shaft fracture if these runners suddenly increase their running mileage within a very short period of time. Running-related bone injuries really seem to be a trend, more so across heel strike runners than forefoot strike runners. And the main reason for this is the stark differences in impact forces produced in heel strike running versus forefoot strike running. Some research has provided key insights into how heel strike running could cause serious bone injuries like a femur fracture. The femur, which is a long bone that connects the hip to the knee and is also the strongest bone in the body, it has been reported that in some cases, long distance runners who have suffered a femur fracture were mostly heel strike runners. Of course, the cause or causes of a running-related bone injury may certainly depend on a variety of factors, from dieting, inadequate conditioning, to doing too much too soon in running volume and intensity, but most evidence to date has strongly supported the idea that the root cause of most running-related femur fractures or long bone injuries is most likely impact-related, and that heel strike runners may be at a greater risk than forefoot strike runners in getting a femur fracture, because what past research has shown us is that in heel strike running, the impact forces usually persist at higher magnitudes, higher amplitudes, and greater intensities than in forefoot strike running. And from this, there's a greater chance of more cumulative strain buildup on the long bones in heel strike running than in forefoot strike running. Again, as a consequence of the impact forces unleashed at heel strike during heel strike running, to which the cumulative strain on the long bones worsens at faster running speeds when running with a heel strike landing pattern. This is a prime example of how landing with a heel strike landing pattern may be the main source of stress implicated in a femur fracture as compared with forefoot running. This evidence of heel strike running generating more intensive impact than forefoot strike running alone is nothing new. But one line of research, which is linked down below in the description box, really takes it one step further in showing us just how slaughtering heel strike running may be to the muscle skeletal system. And that the researchers used a shockwave chronic overload model to reveal just how long bone fractures may develop in habitual shod runners who utilize a heel strike landing when running. But more than that, the model looks at exactly what's happening to the bones after impact is produced at heel strike during heel strike running. The researchers showed that at heel strike, a spontaneous impact transient force is produced. It's very important to always remember that this force is only produced in heel strike running. This type of force is not produced in forefoot strike running. The heel strike impact transient force is also compounded and accompanied with impact shock loads that floods into the bones of the lower body as well as penetrates into the long bones like the femur. These two impact force variables, the heel strike impact transient force coupled with impact shock loads, are propagated as a shock wave that travels up the leg and may result in chronic overloading on the long bones, whereby this type of chronic overloading on the long bones may offset or derail the balance between micro damage formation and its removal within the bone matrix framework, eventually leading to bone fatigue as the chronic overloading of the bone or the femur in this worst case scenario exceeds the capacity of the femur to resist this type of loading. The femur may then crack under this kind of mechanical pressure, stress, and strain. So this may be the connection between increased risk of a femur fracture and heel strike running. And I think it's certainly very important to acknowledge that this kind of evidence really reminds us that how we use our feet when we run may be a key factor in preventing bone injuries or causing bone injuries. In that regard, evolutionarily speaking, if we as humans were essentially born to run, how could running contribute to a major running injury like a femur fracture? The answer could be that the injured runner was using a foot strike pattern that humans didn't evolve for, which is most likely a heel strike landing pattern. I like to consider the forefoot strike landing pattern as ancient biomechanics because it enabled our barefoot running ancestors to run virtually without injuries. Think about it. Our ancestors, at some point in time, shared the common need for running in order to eat. And they ran without shoes, therefore they needed to run in an impact protective friendly way using a running style that made them virtually injury proof. Because if they had bone injuries, they wouldn't have been able to run and thus eat. We then would have died out fast. Fast forward to now, according to Dr. Daniel Lieberman, evolutionary biologist at Harvard University, who has done groundbreaking work on comparing the impact differences between heel strike running and forefoot strike running, has revealed that one of the most essential features of a forefoot strike landing pattern during running is the complete removal of the spontaneous impact transient force and high impact loads, helping give you more protective means to avoid a long bone injury. And it's this impact protective nature of the forefoot strike that enables barefoot runners, as most barefoot runners typically land with a forefoot strike, to avoid impact related injury without the help of cushioned running shoes. And we've seen a wealth of this in experimental, clinical, and in the anecdotal data in support of this. This is why I always like to point to forefoot strike running and helping you naturally move away from repetitive exposure to chronic overloading, because the hallmark of the forefoot strike involvement in injury prevention is the removal of the spontaneous impact force, as well as the dramatic reduction in impact loads, giving you more confidence that you may be able to make more progress in injury prevention with forefoot running. And I always like to put special emphasis on using barefoot running to help you quickly and more effectively develop a more targeted forefoot strike landing pattern. And not just that, running barefoot will also naturally help integrate additional mechanical and reflexive modifications tied to lighter, safer, more responsive stride mechanics as well. I hope you've enjoyed this video. To stay updated on all the latest research regarding the health and performance benefits of barefoot running and forefoot running, please hit the subscribe button down below. Thank you so much for listening and watching. Have fun out there on the roads and trails. Bye for now.